Today's password, yesterday. We miss it all week.
Oh, good.
Thank you.
How much of the job is the last? How much of the job is the last?
How do you open yourself up when you know it's not good enough? yet, or right. You know that there's going to be so much that needs to change. It's just kind of, that's like, I feel like I stepped over a hill that I thought was the summit and just saw another mountain.
That's really great. That's really great. Wow, so you heard Harrison's question, right? He's at that point now. He's finished his draft. He's done a lot of work. And he's finished his draft. And now, okay, you want to open yourself up, open the process up to others. You wanted to do some. How long has it been since you finished it?
About a
month. Because it's cooled off and had to finish it yesterday. So let's see, have you to play?
Musical.
Musical. So you play musical also?
No, I'm working with a composer.
Okay.
And the music's not totally done yet.
Okay. So you have them, you've written the book. So you have them to talk to.
Yeah.
Have you talked to them and read them with them?
Yes.
Okay. Have you read out loud to yourself?
Not out loud, but
okay. So do that. And make a list of everything that you need to work on. A list of what is not working and a list of what is working. Do you want to do that out to yourself? Make a list of what works in your mind. Make a list of what doesn't work in your mind. And then choose, some active friends who are maybe better friends than they are actors. You know what I mean? They're pretty active. They really know their area and they want them to succeed. And they really don't care if you include their ideas in your music or not. And hang out in their apartment. Really low key, close friends.
Yeah.
I suggest. And then get their feedback from close friends. Right? Or you can hang out with a friend and have input. It might be nice to maybe think if you have like a drama show or a friend or if you can put your back in order and talk about it afterwards. Right? Okay. So take those steps. There are huge steps for their manager.
Right.
Right.
And I want them to feel good about that.
Right.
But I don't want it to solidify this story into something. because I tend to get stuck to just commit to any old direction of the story because I want it ready.
Did you hear everybody in here? This is a question she's got to play. Everything after the last, and it sounded like it was going to be a shock. So,
And I would hate to spend 2 years here and not ever have anything produced. So it's sort of, I don't know how to do that. Like, and I don't think that's something we get in my program.
Right.
So it's just, I know it's me, which I'm really good at.
Right.
But I always feel like I'm imposing on people. I'll read other people's work. I'm like good at that, but I don't. Like, I'll end up a script doctor at this rate.
Right.
Yeah.
That's a good question. So, Stacey wonders, you know, how does she get herself out there? So, can you reciprocate? Someone asks you their work, you can ask them. So, everybody who asks you their work and you read their work, you know, they go, from now on, if you're honest, it's just math. It's not about your feelings.
Right.
It's not about your gun shines. You've been shot. Like, in that kind of way, I've been shot at,
but that's another show.
I've had an experience where I've asked someone
to read my work.
Yeah.
And I've never heard anything else. And I know, and I happen to know, like, one thing I am okay with is, like, I know when a piece of mine is strong and I know when it's not.
Right.
So I don't think it was because the piece was just so bad that
right.
they never responded. But they just never did.
Right.
And so it's just like that, I think that experience kind of scarred me to asking people to commit to read 80, 90 pages of my work and critique it.
Right. So there's two things. One, you have to ask, if you see some people out there in the world who you think you could be as responders of your work, then and you want them to read your work, you have to ask them.
Okay.
You have to know the reality of the reality of the world is that, number one, people who can't say no, who say, sure, I'll read your work and never read it because they don't have time. Nobody has time.
Really.
Right. I mean, gosh, you know, unless you're a person who takes scripts home and all that stuff, and that's your everyday. But the people who say no to your face, you mean well. I mean, it's not you. Someone will say, can you remember? And I'll say, no, I can't.
No,
I'm not able. You know, and so I think that, but you keep, I hope the person doesn't take it personally when the person they ask says, I'm sorry, I cannot do it.
Right.
You know, it's not about the person asking, this person over here. It's about, and my back wall.
Right.
A lot of people have back wall. A lot of people will come and show you, sure.
Is it too much to do something like, okay, I'm going to give you this play,
and if you don't feel like you can read it by this date, I understand, and then I'll ask someone else. Like, is that irrational?
Well, can you have two people or five people or hundred people do the same way at the same time?
Probably.
You know what I mean?
place or just like saying, hey. See you next week.
Okay. 5 5 about 9. Thank you.